Well, unfortunately, we weren't invited to share the briefings with the government as the leader of the opposition was. And I believe that this stems from our voicing our dissent on certain issues. As much as we want to work together as much as possible, I think it's healthy for any opposition member of parliament to freely voice their dissent. And even though it's sad that we haven't been able to have any input in the process, at the same time one could say that it frees up opposition voices in order to provide that balance in the democratic system at such a crucial time as well.
You've welcomed the government's plans, but you've called for a degree of enforcement for those who flout social distancing rules. Can you just elaborate on that? Do you mean, for example, on-the-spot fines?
We believe that it puts the onus a lot on the individual, and we think that there has to be a more comprehensive system for enforcement, whether it is on-the-spot fines or more monitoring by officials and public servants who are involved in ensuring that people are keeping in with the social distancing regulations.
The WHO has said that there isn't enough evidence either for or against the use of masks, and Public Health Gibraltar has therefore advised that those who are indoors and can't observe social distancing rules should wear a mask. But you're calling for everyone indoors to wear masks at all times. On what basis do you say that?
The issue here is to apply the precautionary principle, which is that when there isn't solid evidence, it doesn't mean that it's not the case. It just means that maybe there hasn't been enough of a timeline to achieve that solid evidence, and therefore apply the precautionary principle on the side of caution and have an extra filter. Masks should be worn and there should be a clear regulation, and governments should be helping by providing businesses and indoor spaces with masks in order to protect people from each other.
What are your thoughts on the road closures, especially given that they were included in Together Gibraltar's manifesto?
Well, of course, it was part of Together Gibraltar's plan, and we're very proud that we can see that the government is moving in that direction. And in order for this to happen, we need a real vision and a real plan. And therefore, we believe that a staged or a phased approach to this, as was in our manifesto, which was over a four-year period, in order to deliver this new green infrastructure, is the way forward. And in principle, therefore, we commend this plan. What you can't do, and what I don't think the government has done correctly, is, for example, give incentives to people to buy polluting cars over this COVID period where they are exempt from duty, because the message on the green agenda there is inconsistent and I don't think helps with what we all want to achieve in the long term.
Well, the government has said that it's going to be reintroducing clinical procedures, operations. Are you satisfied with the timeline for that?
As well as returning to normality, there is going to be an element of backlog, which we implore on the government to take as a matter of maximum priority in order for this not to have a long-term impact on people's health.